This video is brought to you by Policy Genius. It's been almost 4 years since I installed solar panels on my house, which is located in Massachusetts. In general, they've been performing pretty close to what was promised, but last year threw some curveballs that made me a little concerned. I saw a pretty sharp decline in the amount of solar produced, and since my solar panels are nearing their 4-year anniversary, I thought it'd be a good idea to share what I've learned living with solar panels in an area that you might not think they're good for, as well as what happened last year. And do I still think that getting solar panels was a good idea? Let's see if we can come to a decision on this. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. If you haven't seen my previous videos on my solar panel installation, I'll include links in the description so you can check them out. I won't rehash everything that I've covered in those videos, but in short, I live in the Boston area and have been documenting what it's been like living with a 9.49 kilowatt solar panel system in a colder climate. My wife and I decided to get solar for two main reasons. The first, reduce our electric bill and save money over time. And the second, get as much of our electricity from clean sources as possible. Now, there's no question where my electricity is coming from when it's being produced on my roof. You could probably also include a third reason into the mix, which is my Tesla Model 3. And charging up your EV with electricity that you generate yourself is really cool. I guess you could say I like the idea of energy independence. It's kind of exciting. Now, my house has a few challenges. If you live in the Northern Hemisphere, it's best to have a southern-facing roof to maximize your solar production. But my house is oriented from east to west, and that's why I have panels on both sides of my roof, so I can capture the morning and afternoon sun. Not ideal, but it does work. The second issue is that my roof is pretty small. And finally, I have a fair amount of trees on the western side of my house that start to block the sun in the mid to late afternoon. Like I said, my house is a bit challenging for solar. But for the past few years, my solar panels have reduced our reliance on the grid by about 54%, which is what we expected given my home's issues. Now, we're still on track for the system to have paid for itself in savings by 2026. It's a 7 to 8 year payback period. But there's some wrinkles to that that I'll get to in a little bit. First, though, I've got to get into last year's issues. We saw a pretty steep drop in performance in 2021, but it's really important to give these numbers some context. If you don't have solar, it's easy to armchair quarterback and ridicule solar as a waste of money. And some of the comments I see the most often on my solar panel videos bring up the misperception that solar panels degrade and die quickly. Others question the accuracy of solar installers telling you how much you'll produce each year, sometimes for the next 10, 15, or 20 years. Now, weather is going to be a huge factor in how well your solar panel system works. The criticism is usually, if a meteorologist struggles to predict the weather a week out, how can you predict years of solar production? On the first point about degradation, it's absolutely true that you'll see a decline year over year. However, if you have quality made panels from the major manufacturers that are out there, these panels will last for 30 or more years. For these panels, you'll have warranties that guarantee a minimal loss over the next 20 years. But that's not end of life, that's just the warranty period. In my case, I have LG solar panels on my home that are guaranteed to produce at least 88.4% of their original efficiency, which means that you're talking about a 0.5% drop each year. And that's why I had to raise an eyebrow at last year's numbers. My solar installer offers a 10-year production guarantee. If my panels produce less than 95% of their projection, they'll pay the difference in the cost of electricity. They projected that we'd be producing close to about 6,600 kilowatt hours each year for the first few years. But last year, we produced only 6,479 kilowatt hours. And the year before, we produced about 7,293 kilowatt hours. So comparing 2021 to 2020, we saw an 11% drop in production. So yeah, I was a little perplexed, frustrated, with a dash of concern. To add to that, our electricity use had actually increased slightly because my wife started working from home because of the pandemic. And our electricity prices had risen a lot. Back when we got the solar panels installed, we were paying about 24 cents per kilowatt hour. Now we're paying about 30 cents per kilowatt hour. On average, we use about 950 kilowatt hours per month over the course of a year. So you're talking about going from a potential bill of $228 just a few years ago to $285 today. That's when the data nerd in me kicked into gear and I started crunching the numbers to figure out what was going on. Before getting into what I found, there's some other numbers worth crunching. I've been asked on previous solar panel videos how much my home insurance went up with my solar panels, and that really depends on your insurance provider, but my home insurance didn't change at all with the solar. But we're planning on moving at some point soon, so we've been looking around to see if there's better deals for our home and auto insurance, and that's where today's sponsor, Policy Genius, comes in. Now, Policy Genius makes it crazy easy to find and compare insurance coverage that's right for you. They don't sell your personal info to third parties, they have thousands of 5-star reviews on Google and Trustpilot, and they've helped over 30 million people shop for insurance since 2014. Now, it couldn't be easier to get started. Head over to policygenius.com/undecided and answer just a few quick questions about yourself and your property. Policy Genius will show you the price estimates for the types of policies that you're looking for, and their team of experts look for ways to save you more, especially if you bundle your home and auto insurance. And finally, Policy Genius works for you, not the insurance companies. So if they find you a better rate than what you're paying now, they'll switch you over for free. Policy Genius has saved customers an average of $1,250 per year over what they were paying for home and auto insurance before. Now head over to policygenius.com/undecided to get your free home and auto insurance quotes and see how much they could save you. Thanks to Policy Genius and to all of you for supporting the channel. Now back to what I found after digging into my solar production data. Now when looking at your solar production, it's important to not focus and obsess on the day-to-day numbers. There's going to be an incredible amount of volatility day-to-day depending on the weather. So cloudy days, rain, snow, you get the idea. It all depends, so you have to take a longer-term view when assessing how it's performing and if it's worth the cost of the system. It's the same reason my solar installer does a yearly guarantee. Take a look at my monthly numbers year over year and you'll start to spot some clear trends. Summer is obviously going to be the peak production period because of the increased daylight hours and the sun being at a higher angle in the sky. During winter, you have shorter days and lower angle of sun. The early trend looks a lot like the daily trend. Very low production in the winter and none at night, and a swell during the summer months and middle of the day. However, something should jump out at you on this chart. The 2021 numbers between May and September are dramatically lower than the years before. Now, I knew weather was going to play a role in how effective my panels would be and perform over time, but I didn't expect such a huge swing to happen year over year. That's when I pulled up the historical weather data for my area. Now, if you overlay the amount of precipitation on top of the solar production chart, the correlation is pretty clear. Here in the New England area, 2021 was one of the warmest and wettest on record, especially if you look at the July, August, and September data. 2021 was the third warmest record going all the way back to 1895. It was also the third wettest year on record, and July 2021 coming in as the warmest month on record. Massachusetts typically sees about 4 inches of rain in July, but last year we saw an average of 10.3 inches. So the mystery was solved for why last year's production was so low. It wasn't anything wrong with my panels, inverters, or other hardware. And thankfully, if you look at what we've seen so far in 2022, everything seems to be back to normal. In fact, April's production numbers were the best we've seen so far after 4 years of data. While you might think that this challenged my belief in vetting solar production numbers from year to year versus day to day, and that weather doesn't really factor in too much long term, it hasn't. 2021's yearly number came in at 6,479.6 kilowatt hours, with a prediction from my installer at 6,549 kilowatt hours. That prediction was off by about 1%, which really isn't that bad at all. The variability in seasonal weather conditions is factored into the historical data that solar installers pull from to make the future prediction numbers. And from what I'm seeing, it's pretty accurate. Even though I've seen wild swings between a couple of years, 2020 was about 10.8% higher than predicted. They worked out the prediction on the conservative side of things of what we might see. And that brings me to the giant question of, do I still think it was worth it? If you've watched my previous videos on my solar panels, you'll know that I've said in each one of these, the answer is yes. But you'll also know that I've always stressed very hard that it's going to depend on what your personal goals are. Anyone that tells you that solar panels are worth it no matter what should be ignored. And the same is true for anyone that says solar panels are a scam and will never work. Solar panels are just another method of producing electricity and don't necessarily make sense for every person in every situation in every location. For me, I live in an area without time-of-use electricity rates, but we do have net metering that pays back nearly 1-to-1 credits on my electric bill. So we bank some credits in the summer that wipe out our electric bills in those months and into the fall, and during the winter we primarily pull from the grid, just like anybody else. We also have solar renewable energy credits, or SRECs. We're getting $126.22 a month in SREC credits for 10 years. So we'll be seeing about $15,146 from that. And that leaves us on the hook for about $12,380 out of pocket for the cost of our solar panels. But then you have to look at the money that we're saving from our electric bill. We were spending about $2,600 a year on electricity, but we've been saving almost $1,500 a year with solar. And since our electricity prices have risen to about 30 cents per kilowatt hour, our savings has actually gone up a little bit. Now, all of that rolled together is how our solar panel system will pay for itself sometime in 2026. And the panels should easily go another 20 years or more after that. So they'll be producing free, clean electricity at that point. Again, I can't stress this enough, the warranty period is not the end of life for the panel. But here's the wrinkle that I brought up earlier about my specific return on investment. I'm not going to be living in my house in 2026. I'm not going to be living in this house next year. My wife and I are building a new modular net zero home this year, and we'll hopefully be moving in early next year sometime. That means we'll be selling our current home with the solar panels before they've returned on their investment, which means we're only about halfway into that payback period. Am I going to lose out on that money? Am I going to have a hard time selling my home with the solar panels on it? On that first point, no. I'm not going to be selling my solar panels at a loss. A home's value actually increases with solar panels. It's not that different from doing a kitchen or a bathroom renovation. And solar panels are very popular in my area. Energysage has a great article that details the impacts to a home's value. According to a study by Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory, which used data from about 8 states over a course of an 11-year period, you can expect to see about a $4 per watt of installed solar capacity added to the value of your current home. In my case, that could be an increase of $38,000. To me, that sounds a little too high, but according to Zillow, they saw homes with solar panels selling for 4.1% more. And the National Renewable Energy Laboratory reported seeing an increase in home value by $20 for every $1 reduction in annual utility bills. That math would work out to about $30,000 for my house, which isn't that far off from the first study. The bottom line, the more money your solar panels save you on electricity, the more it increases your house's value. Seems pretty straightforward when you think about it. I won't have to wait too much longer to find out how that holds true, so stay tuned to the channel if you want to hear about how selling my house went with the solar panels, as well as a ton of videos on my upcoming house build. So do I still think getting solar panels for my home was worth it? The big answer is yes. For my goals, which was saving money on electricity over time and ensuring that my power was coming from a clean energy source, it ticked all the boxes. Now, our system cost $20,727 after the federal tax credit. By the time we leave this house, we'll have received about $6,000 in SREC payments, about $1,500 a year in electricity savings, so add another $6,000 on top of that. We'll have whittled the payback down to about $8,000 by the time we leave. And if that $30,000 increase in value holds true, the return on investment will have been well worth it. But that wasn't my only goal. Again, I did this for some energy independence and to ensure I was getting energy from a clean source. Would I recommend that you get solar? Well, that's tricky because I don't know your goals, where you live, or what the costs are in your area. So you're going to need to do the evaluation for yourself. But if you are thinking about it, don't wait much longer. If you live in the US, the federal solar tax credit is going to be dropping from 26% to 22% in 2023. Solar installers are booking up fast, so you really need to schedule installers to ensure your panels get installed before the end of this year. Now, I've been getting quotes for my new house, and installers are already booked up through August and September. So start looking today and evaluating if it's the right choice for you. And on that note, you should check out Energysage for great articles and reviews on solar equipment. I found them to be an amazing resource when researching my current installation as well as my next one. I also used Energysage to find my installer on my current house. Now, if you live in the US, check out my Energysage portal to find installers in your area and get quotes. Now, full transparency, this is an affiliate program, so I do get a small commission if you use my portal. But regardless of that, I love Energysage and find them a great resource. My favorite part of finding an installer through them is that you're not giving up your personal information and phone number to get deluged with dozens of calls. All the quotes are delivered to your Energysage account and are presented in a way that's easy for apples-to-apples comparisons between the different installers. I strongly recommend it. So what do you think? Do you want solar panels for your home? Jump in the comments and let me know. If you liked this video, be sure to check out one of the ones I've linked over here. And thanks to all of my patrons for your continued support. And welcome to new producers Michael Maxey, Greg McWilliam, and Jay. And thanks to all of you for watching. See you in the next one.